Sir, I wish to be the part of the government mechanism. And secondly, sir, it's considered to be one of the best services in the country. So it gives me a good career option.
So what qualities will you bring to this job?
Sir, I think my compassionate nature, my confidence and integrity would help me. And secondly, thirdly, sir, that in times of crisis, I don't give up easily. So I think that will help me.
Good. Very good. You should also mention things like honesty, integrity, professional competence. You strive for profession. You believe in rule of law. You have moral courage and readiness to handle crisis. These qualities are required for these jobs, which you should always mention.
Homework. Are you doing some job now?
Yes, sir.
So last job you were doing, you have left that?
Yes, sir, I left.
Okay. So you are preparing, and this is your first interview?
This is my second attempt and second interview.
Okay. Tell me, political science and international relation is your optional. Why political science is called a science?
Sir, it is called a science because of the use of experimentation techniques and the data analysis that is being done recently. Mm-hmm. So it cannot be considered as a natural science, but it is an inexact science. So from there it is considered as a science, a part of social science.
And behaviorism and post-behaviorism, can you mention something about them?
Sir, behaviorism was an attempt to make political science purely data-based. Mm. It was after the Second World War. Mm. And use of experimentation, analysis, research was focused on that. Mm. But it was led by David Easton. Mm. But during that time, David Easton felt that because of these things, they have ignored the current current happenings around the world. So therefore, he realized that political science should be both data as well as value-based. So that made him, he only propagated the idea of post-behavioralism.
Okay. You see, now China in some circles is being described as a disruptive power in India's country. Do you agree?
Yes, sir, we can.
Please tell me why it is being said so.
Sir, because of the policies that are followed by China. Hmm. The recent being the its manipulation of the currency, which is problematic for trade. Secondly, sir, the its geopolitical aspects. Examples are in South China Sea, there are disputes are going on. Sir, with the Belt and Road Initiative, the debt trap policy of China, where small countries, they give high amount of loans and they get indebted to China. And sir, these things can be
considered. Why India is so much concerned about the growing influence of China in Indian Ocean?
Sir, there are multiple reasons for that. Hmm. Sir, one is the security reason that China is considering itself as the master of South China Sea, with disputes all the countries, and which is interrupting the freedom of navigation as well as the communication lanes, which might hamper the trade prospects for India in that region, sir.
My Indian Ocean has so much strategic importance for India. You should start with that. How it is there. Okay, then tell me, you know, in international relation, now it is not a bipolar war, it's a multipolar war. What should be the kind of, you know, strategy, foreign policy strategy, of country like India? Should it be aligned to US? Should it be, you know, what kind of alignment, what kind of policy, what kind of strategy it should adopt?
Sir,
multipolar one.
So the strategies that one should adopt should be selective based on, it should not be guided by ideology, but by our national interest in terms of economy, in terms of our national security, and in terms of our improvement in our cultural relations, so that India can project itself as a leader. So, sir, when we analyze this, when we see this policy trend, sir, wherever we can see, we have to meet our energy security, so we can increase our engagement with the Middle East. Sir, we need to improve our trade. Act this policy is focusing on ASEAN as a market. Sir, we need entry in United Nations Security Council, NSG. So therefore, we are engaging with more and more countries to build
consensus. Multi-alignment. Okay. Now tell me, this white revolution, you know about white revolution?
Sir, a little about it, sir.
It is about what?
Sir, it's about the milk production in the country.
Why it became a success? What is the root of its secret behind its success?
Sir, I think the secret behind would be the success of the cooperative movement.
That is the reason. Involvement of the
grassroots farmers, which have their dairy, with they collectivize their milk production, and hence we could expand our production.
Correct. Thank you.
Mr. Srivastava?
Yes.
You are a mechanical engineer from BIT Vellore. Who established BIT Vellore?
Sir, BIT was established by Mr. G. Vishwanathan.
When?
So in 1984.
Yes. Now, how this knowledge will be helpful to you as a civil servant?
Sir, here I'd like to say two things, sir. As an engineer, sir, I have skills which promote resource optimization and problem-solving approach. And sir, as a mechanical engineer specifically, sir, there are techniques like PERT and CPM which help in project management. Also, sir, in coming years, we'll be more guided by a technology like drone technology for surveillance as well as farm management. Also, sir, robotics is coming up. So I think these things will...
Why there is an impression in the country that at the grassroots level, there is a disconnect with the CGL.
Sir, one reason is that people are not aware about the schemes and policies of the government. So they do not have the knowledge to approach for their rights. Sir, second reason is the insensitivity of the grassroots officials, which consider themselves as rulers rather than servants, so which has decreased the faith of people in the administration.
So, as an IAS officer at your DM, will you be able to do so?
Sir, I'd be able to do it. I have to make the administration reach out to the people. The deficit between the...
How?
Sir, that can be that openness of the district administration to people, if they can come and register their complaints. Also, sir, social media can be used for their grievance redressal mechanisms.
What do you know about the Make in India program?
Sir, the Make in India program was launched in 2014 to make India a hub for design, innovation and manufacturing. And
any concrete success stories?
Sir, concrete success stories are not finalized at the moment, but they are in the pipeline. Like 47 German companies are ready to invest in India. And sir,
there are no concrete success.
Sir, I'm not aware of any big, but in bits and pieces, sir, electronic industry, it's growing, sir.
In railways, they have done a lot.
I'll read on this.
And what about a Skill in India program? Why it is not succeeding?
Sir, there are multiple reasons for that. One reason is, sir, the skills that are being promoted in Skill India, they get obsolete very fast in terms of innovative technology. Second, sir, most of the jobs are being automated, so the requirements of people is less.
About employment, there are two views. One says there is jobless growth in India. Other says, you know, there is no job drought. In fact, there is shortage of manpower. Jobs are there. Which one do you think is correct and why?
Sir, I was reading about this, and both the reports, they have quoted their data with respect to the job.
What is your view?
Sir, here I would say that we are shifting from the traditional concept of job to work, that from the entrepreneurship schemes as well as the Skill India scheme, people are focusing towards their own enterprises. So maybe the formal sector jobs are not creating, but people in future, they will get jobs.
What do you know about the central budget?
Sir, there are a few major aspects of budget. One was the Ayushman Bharat scheme that was launched. And second, sir, the in agriculture sector, many reforms were there, sir. First was giving the MSP 1.5 times the cost. Second, sir, integration of rural markets into Grameen hearts, rural hearts into Grameen markets. And
what about defense and infrastructure?
So that
ma'am?
You are interested in cricket. Why was the recent IPL match shifted out of Chennai?
Ma'am, it was because of the protests in Chennai regarding the Cauvery Management Board issue, where they protested against the central government for its delay in implementation of the Supreme Court verdict.
So who asked that the Cauvery Board should be constituted? Was it based on the Supreme Court judgment?
Ma'am, Supreme Court had mentioned only the scheme, the word scheme. So
what did the Supreme Court say in their judgment regarding Cauvery sharing of waters?
Ma'am, the judgment in February?
Yes.
Ma'am, it has the Supreme Court judgment had increased the share of Karnataka in the, by 14 TMC feet.
Okay, but why?
Ma'am, because of the ongoing crisis in Bangalore.
They enunciated three principles. One is right, ongoing crisis of drinking water in Bangalore. And the other two?
Ma'am, one was that Cauvery should be considered as a national asset.
Yes.
And third one.
And they also took into account the groundwater available.
Yes, ma'am, Tamil Nadu groundwater is available.
Yes, so because of that, so now where has the, have the games been shifted to?
Ma'am, they have been shifted to Pune.
Okay, it's final?
I think so.
Alright. Now you also taken part in writing for the Hindu.
No, ma'am.
What is this you've written? Chapter of newspaper, The Hindu.
Ma'am, this was a club that I started.
Okay, so that was called The Hindu?
The Hindu Education Plus Club. It's a student chapter of The Hindu newspaper.
So what did you do? What was your role there?
Ma'am, I founded that club because the newspaper, The Hindu, they had an observation that people in academic backgrounds, they only focus on their curriculum and they are not aware about their general surroundings, the current affairs. So this club was focused on developing leadership skills among the students so that they understand issues going around.
So how did you develop the leadership skills for your other fellow members?
Ma'am, we had many events going on continuously, like debates, discussions, and people were made to take part in them. So they had an understanding of the issue.
Now you've also written graphology. What is graphology?
Ma'am, graphology is handwriting analysis.
Can you analyze handwriting?
I might try to.
But handwritings keep changing.
Ma'am, they keep changing, but at a particular moment, some things can be figured out. It's not a science, so it's purely on interpretive basis.
Okay.
So it's
just to embrace.
It's a recreational.
All right, good. Now you're from Uttar Pradesh, and one hears of all these encounters. Mm-hmm. Are encounters a good technique to get down crime and address the law and order situation?
Ma'am, I think encounters are justified only in the case of self-defense.
Yes.
And they
only
should not.
In the case of self-defense.
They should not be made a norm. Our focus should be on to establish rule of law based on the principles in our constitution, like faith in our police system. People should approach the police. The proper trial should take place. Investigation should take place.
Okay, good. Now we find that there are protests of the rights, and these protesters become violent many times, whether it was caste-based protests or it was protest against the SCSC judgment which just came, or it is against a movie. Are we becoming intolerant as a society?
Ma'am, as a society, I would agree to this, but I would say that there are some fringe elements which are becoming intolerant, and because of the they utilize the insecurities in the people through social media and instigating them that such and such thing will be bad for you. I think that is the creation that we that is the reason why a large section of people we see protesting against.
All right. Now, can you mention some of the internal security problems which our country faces today?
Ma'am, internal security problems would be the insurgency,
insurgency
in Jammu Kashmir, in Northeast, in Chhattisgarh. Ma'am, second would be drug trafficking and human trafficking, which is a part of organized crime.
Yes.
Ma'am, another would be cyber security issues.
Yes.
Communal rights. Yeah.
So tell me something about this left-wing extremism. LW, which are the states which are affected by it?
Ma'am, the major states that are affected by it are Chhattisgarh, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh.
Not Andhra Pradesh anymore?
Yes, ma'am.
They've been able to.
Yes, they have.
And
Jharkhand.
Yes, Jharkhand, Telangana. Just mention, what are the global challenges which our country faces today? Just mention them, I don't want any details.
One is terrorism.
Terrorism.
Second is climate change.
Climate change.
And third, I would say, is the trade issues, protectionism.
All right. And pandemics, illnesses, diseases.
Yes, ma'am, the health issues.
Health issues. Money laundering, piracy. All right. Thank you.
One more. For a while, I find that you work as training decision scientists.
Yes.
In NU Sigma Business Solutions. What exactly was the problem?
Sir, this company deals with big data analytics. Mm-hmm. I was a part of a retail company where I worked as an assortment planning.
The marketing concern?
Sir, it's purely big data analytics. It was my job was yes, it can be related to marketing because my job was assortment planning. So we used to tell our clients which products to be kept in which stores.
Okay.
So it's a part of marketing.
I'll ask you something general. How do you look at the state of the Indian economy?
Sir, I would say that the economy is recovering at the moment because there are some issues. Our statistics which...
I would like you to examine on the basis of certain macroeconomic indicators.
Yes, sir. I was coming to that, sir. Sir, the macroeconomic indicators are that current account deficit is 1.8% of the GDP. Then, sir, fiscal deficit...
Which is on the higher side.
Which is on the higher side. Sir, fiscal deficit, our government wasn't able to meet its target and it's 3.5%. So, there we can say that issues are there, but we are on the recovering track. As in the economic survey, it was mentioned that
inflation is under control.
Inflation is under control, but we say that
forex reserves, how much we have?
Sir, so around $420 million.
We have 424.
424.
So that also is fairly satisfactory.
Yes.
There are certain problems on the balance of payment side. You agree about?
Sir, trade deficit is high.
Trade deficit is high, as you said. And future scenario also looks problematic.
Yes.
All imports,
yes.
All prices are on the right.
Prices are on the right.
Prices are on the right. Export is an uncertain area.
Yes.
So, on balance, how would you describe the present state of the economy? In one sentence, if I ask you to explain.
Sir, I would say that the potential is there and we are recovering at the moment. I wouldn't say that we are successful right now, but we are recovering.
We are on the way to recovery. But concerns?
There are concerns.
Okay. What is this investment?
Sir, it's the reduction of government stakes in the public sector units.
Right now, some disinvestment proposals are under consideration of the government.
Sir, Air India.
What do you think about it? You support?
Sir, I would support the disinvestment because of the large debt, the 50,000 crore debt is there for the...
And how actually this disinvestment process is gone through?
Sir, recently some details were given that 76% stakes will be disinvested with 50% stake in the flying and 50% stake in the ground and grounds management and 100% stake in the Indian Express.
There are also, you know, from second quarters, people are saying that we should try to go in for more and more privatization. of the observer banks. What is your take on that?
Sir, the proposal that has been given is on the recent cases of Punjab National Bank issue. But sir, here I would like to say that ownership is not the issue. We need to have some reform measures in the bank governance. That will be more important. Private sector banks are also susceptible.
Absolutely, I think I agree on that. Last question. International Solar Alliance meeting, Delhi hosted last month. How significant is that?
Sir, it is very significant because in future we are aiming at 100 gigawatt target for solar energy, and to achieve the target we need investments in technology as well as skills and manpower. So a collective alliance of these countries will help in achieving.
How many countries are there in this alliance?
Sir, 120 members are there, but the treaty has been ratified by around 60 members, 60
or 60. Any initiative taken during the meeting of the alliance for creation of a fund or things like that?
Sir, I have read
on. You have to read on. Thank you.
Defining mechanical engineering.
Sir, mechanical engineering involves creation of systems based on the concepts of force and motion and energy, so that we can help the. We can make our tasks easier.
Is it a technology? Mechanical engineering is a technology. Application of science.
Yes, sir.
It's a technology.
Sir, technology, sir, it's a process by which a technology is being made. So that is.
What is the difference between mechanical engineering and automation?
Sir, mechanical engineering is a wide subject which involves creation of machines as well as project management as well as plant management.
Automation is a result of mechanical engineering?
Is a part of mechanical engineering.
Part or outcome?
Sir, outcome of one part of mechanical engineering.
What is the difference between robotics and automation?
So there's a very slight difference as far as you can think. Automation involves anything that has been instructed to do a job repeatedly, and robotics involves physical aspects. So I would say that automation is a component of robotics. One component of robotics.
What is the difference between a robot and a drone?
Sir, a robot can be any machine that does work based on the inputs given, and drone is an unmanned aerial vehicle. It's a type of robot.
It's a type of robot?
Yes.
No.
Sir, I'll read on.
Drone is, which is pre-programmed, it does the same work repeatedly. Right? Like putting a part in a machine, in a car, like this. Cutting, it doesn't change its function, whereas a drone can change. It can be controlled from by technology. Correct or not? A drone is flying. You say you go to that target, it goes to that target. Then it's you go to that target.
So I think robots can also be maneuvered.
Robot can be maneuvered.
Yes.
Are there any field in which robots are they maneuverable? They can perform multi-tasks.
Sir, the recent robot that has been created by Japan, sir, Asimo, it is a movable robot. It can do multiple things. It is based on artificial intelligence, sir. Then recently, the Sophia robot was launched by a company. It is also capable of answering.
They are capable of multitasking. Define robotics.
Sir, robotics would be a branch of science which will, it is a combination of mechanical engineering as well as electronics engineering to create systems that may or may not have intelligence to do work, but they can do works repeatedly.
Is government of India adopting technology, embracing technology?
Yes, sir.
Give some evidence.
Sir, one is the e-governance, where internet has been used to deliver services to the people directly. Sir, other aspects would be, sir, government is shifting towards electrical vehicles, and it is focusing on electrical vehicles, sir. So technology can be considered as, it is a part of our delivery system.
What is the government's approach towards artificial intelligence?
Sir, recently Niti Aayog had a proposal to consider the aspects of artificial intelligence in health, education and sectors which are hazardous, their artificial intelligence can be.
All right, we close the interview.